was just good football.
So I'm just doing... And I'm going to continue what I was doing last time, because since it stopped working, I pretty much uploaded the clips to YouTube. I continued playing and uploaded it to YouTube, so... Oh... Right out. You're beautiful! You're beautiful!
I told them over 2 years ago that I'm here to wreck everyone, and then I'm leaving. And that's exactly what we did tonight. We worked real, and now we're leaving. But before we go, wise man, there's one thing left to do.
I don't play WWE 2K22 anymore.
Acknowledge me.
I'm hate no sense.
Oh wait, this video. Okay. Number one on trending. YouTube is realizing Koi Kenshin's catching on to me. But just go to Koi X Kenshin on YouTube, watch his newest video. Because he calls out YouTube. And they deserve it. Yeah. Get him with the good. Get him with the good old Vine Boom sound, like boom, boom, boom. Awkward attacks. And then just a cartwheel kick someone tried to hit on Tony Ferguson. Justin Gaethje's not human. UFC? I trusted it. I hit you on that silly. You said you needed 5. That was more than 12 ago. I'm stuck like that. I don't understand this video. I skip these ads.
You guys remember the first time you had on yesterday? Uniform necessities, multiples are her thing. Now your neighbor won't speak to me. I don't know if you know.
I'm not a few fake laughs. She's talking my ear off.
Gain any sort of awareness about how your body is called never what about 2 years? Anything before that will basically just stimulize your
pre-programmed hacking. Ha ha ha! King noise is it!
Sitting on my parents' bed, watching my brother play Mario Sunshine on the very small TV that they had ever had in my life. And I took a sip, and I think it connected a wire.
I remember waiting for my mom to come home. I just remember staring at the door and realizing I'm a whole ass human being.
Started walking into the living room and started being furious about everything. Woke up and it was just a dream.
Barely.
Please let me take that video.
Oh my god!
I think I hit my friend with a bat. I was on a couch, and I
was so small that I hit my friend with a bat. That is what I do.
My obese ginger cat named Bruce scratched me in the eyeball, and I started screaming, and that's my first memory.
Yeah, so I took a shit on the toilet.
Ah, Mr. Nevercake, thank you for joining. What was your first sentient memory? Yeah, let me show you how to be a star.
I became kind of now a little baby eating some spaghetti going spaghetti.
I was like three, and my body didn't all look like me. I was so furious that some kid I didn't even know existed was now occupying my home, and I screamed at him, ran into my dad's room, and locked myself in there until I got hungry and dinner was ready.
So I was waiting out to my family to go to this small like place, and I remember being at the small beach looking at all the toys on the ground. I then proceeded to grab myself profusely.
I distinctly remember being in a stroller and the feeling of being rolled over those little corner bumps on a sidewalk. Which is why I made this cryptic-ass tweet a year ago.
So I was watching TV with my swimsuit on, waiting for my dad to take me to the pool. And he finally got ready to come into the room of a sobbing child at the age of 6, realizing that she will die one day.
Oh man, I remember quitting. I wanted so badly to be that I fucking despised milk and wanted to cut that grin. But alas,
I was leaving the movie theater as a young babe and ragdolled down all four flights of stairs. Just brain off, no control of my body, Brian hit by a car rolling down all the stairs. My earliest memory is having an arm cast because apparently, a week before I gained sentience, I'd been climbing on this upright piano my parents had. I tripped on a phone cord, fell off, and broke my arm.
When I was 3, I was playing in the bathtub, and when I slipped and fell, I nearly blinded myself in one eye on the edge of the shower. I gained sentience with the skin around my eye being sewn up, and I don't remember why they couldn't give me anything for the numbing or to knock me out.
I remember gaining sentience after hitting a big glass roll with my head and breaking it. I think it was Buddy.
Everyone's got a different experience turned out. Some normal, and some not. So tell me yours in the comments below, and thank you so much for enjoying this time. It's not usually what I do, but everyone really liked the last video I did, and I'm so thankful again, because I'm not gonna lie, this is really fun. And taking the time to make these kinds of videos instead of burning my...
You got suplexed in a boxing match? What? That's illegal!
Did I not get 2 running backs that strip up?
Alright, so we back in Hold My Nugget Studios once again for another rough and rowdy competition.
Round 1.
Ticker.
With the red gloves, government assistance, discount Matthew McConaughey. With the blue gloves, an easy victim of sunburn, the Pale Warrior. Let's get ready to rumble! What incarnation is discount Matthew McConaughey doing? Is he here to box or showcase his pass blocking ability for a possible job as an offensive lineman?
More.
And my homie in the bottom right corner outside the ring wearing a mask. Was he saved by the Joker? Whoever loses this fight is gonna die. Homie just hopping around the ring. What kind of pogo stick training did you go through before accepting this fight? It's as if he's more interested in hugging his opponent than throwing hands. I bet he's the type to get friend zoned for love bombing. Man just tasting every piece of them blue gloves. And why is his sock so high? What is on your shin that you could possibly be hiding from the world?
Shin.
Body blow.
Off of me.
Get the fuck out of here. Bruce. I see why Bailey changed her gimmick. This man's the real hugger.
You let him get away?
What the fuck? What incarnation was that punch? Is he playing whack-a-mole? This man's either a Browns fan or went to college with Miles Garrett. What the hell was that? Second round begins the
he's getting
way
better.
The first one ended. A whole lot of clinching like a woman trying to do a kegel.
This is so fun this year.
Why does he only advance forward and nowhere else?
Enough of this shit.
Now, for a lesson, you may have heard these words before, but I'll teach you what they really mean. Go beyond!
He's next to me.
I bet you $5 you didn't see this coming, and you can turn that same $5 into $200 with DraftKings.
That's how it works.
Wait, no, man, calling all college football fans in Southwest to kick off this week. And whether you're a Tiger, a Duck, a Trojan, maybe even a Roman Tide, there are plenty to do with the Mets sitting around bus with this. That's enough. No! I broke my back. My back is broken. Oh Lord, discount government assistance Matthew McConaughey got slammed.
It hurts my feelings when you do that. It hurts my feelings a lot.
Man's vertebrae is in peril. Got dropped like internet connection inside of a tunnel. But Peapod, a referee, was more concerned than holding the Pale Warrior back than catching discount government assistance Matthew McConaughey. Homie hit the floor harder than self-esteem during a rejection. He already had questionable moves before, but now with a misaligned spine, how will discount government assistance Matthew McConaughey respond now?
The least we can do is hit the reset button.
Golly, the Pale Warrior already caught him with a right hand. Looks like homie trying to respond with a hip toss. He almost punched the referee!
I said it! Everyone's getting a timeout!
This man is out of control! His character indicator... He's getting defeated in every aspect of the fight! He must have learned how to box at the arcade!
Jesus Christ, son! You better get your ass served!
He landed a punch!
He then missed every punch.
Everyone's getting a timeout.
This man tried to throw an elbow. The referee abruptly ended the round with 7 seconds left to spare. He moves around the ring like a fly that refuses to leave your house despite the fact all the windows are open. All up on his opponent like an invincible mosquito. That right hand was the first connection he had all night, but man tried to throw an elbow. He stepped into the ring with his own controller manual.
That team would be a part of it, 2025.
How do you walk into a punch every single round? Coco! He did that hammer whack-a-mole swing again?
Mr. Madhouse,
walk! Almighty push.
He
gotta be one of the most intimate fights I've ever seen in my life.
Come on. They got rid of him the year they won the Super Bowl.
I think the left hand hit the pause button. Why are you not moving? Oh, Lord, he's looking to go for a DDT. The referee's already seen one wrestling maneuver. He refuses to see a second. Fans are still going for them whack-a-mole strikes. When in doubt in a boxing match, throw a backhand. Wait, no. The Pale Warrior goes down. He either got tripped, slipped on a banana, or was contacted by the Holy Spirit, because ain't nothing touching. With under 20 seconds remaining, this is the time for this town government assistance, Matthew McConaughey, to strike. Is that his finishing ever again? Hard. Wait a minute, isn't the fight over? Why is this ring girl holding up the third round sign? Despite the fact that she has some nice bubble action going on back there, all that extra movement, why is her intellect on the same level of a roach? It's quite evident the fight is over. The referee is lifting the hands of the victor. But for whatever reason, this lady takes her time to parade around the ring. As if the fight has not been concluded, she had the audacity, temerity, a mitigated goal to step into the ring with her tongue out, thinking she's doing something special, only to find out that it is her who is special. Special as that is. She's got a condition that a Sinzu bean couldn't cure. She's fucked and stupid. Nevertheless, your victor, by unanimous decision, the Pale Warrior. Now, for old time's sake, let's watch discount clearance aisle, great value, low income, government assistance, Matthew McConaughey gets suplexed into the shadow realm. Finish
him. I don't believe that much in the mouth, though. He just got drunk.
UFC fighters' reaction after seeing Kamaru Usman getting knocked out by Leon Edwards at UFC 270, and the new UFC welterweight champion is Leon Edwards after an insane leg kick that finished Usman round one.
Gilbert Burns, he's shoved
on. Can
you say who that was? You went mad because he lost money. I went with he was holding his daughter because she started crying. Brandon Moreno. Look, this man's like, what just happened? This man was confused. He was confused, flabbergasted, hoodwinked. Other words, he doesn't know what's happening.
No, we no capping it. I like with a stack rocking it. I'm riding up by that stop it, cause it ain't no echoing it. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pretty. Leaving my mark like a, I see no biggie. Call me Hillary, stay at the bank. Making moves like I'm hot on the shank. I'm no keeper, I pop out in blank. This bun on my knife, cause I kinda look. They do not cover me. Fake, I can't keep no company. Only the real respect, my honest. So watch how you come in if you're under me. I'm with it in wrecks and vow. By that text and call, you run me that making no sense at all. That bounce like a basketball, your boo never coming back. This girl stupid, go dumb. Told that boy you gotta pay for some. I sit on no wrong, you ain't taking none. You bragging on pants, I make for fun. I see no biggie. Honestly, I see no biggie. Pay the heavy on pity. You mad, well, I'm getting
busy. I'm here with the winner and new welterweight champion of the world.
It's been a long four years. The old doubt to me said I couldn't do it. The old said I couldn't do it. Look at me now. Look at me. Here we go. That's it. Told it's possible. We can win a battle.
I will always love that fight. One, because of how crazy the knockout was and how his first thing he did. He got up and went towards the camera. When he jumped out from the cage, he went, there is no pound for pound best! There is no pound for pound.
Holy water.
How is that making holy water?
I'm boiling the hell out of it.
I don't use Tinder. I meet girls the old way. Never.
Oh no!
Okay,
tell me you're living in Paris. Without telling me you're living in Paris.
How short is too short?
Literally anything under like 20 minutes.
Tall.
It's important.
Just say it.
To be honest, I'm pregnant. Please wait, baby isn't yours.
Thanks God. Then whose baby is it?
It's ours.
Bro, women aren't funny. Tell me a joke then.
Balls.
My battle scar from last night. Battle scars, did the oven burn you?
Your girl at the Domino's said she drew a face on my box. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. No. Was she cute? I thought she was. Well, that doesn't answer the question.
Oh, Lord.
Before I turn it on, though, I need to turn you guys on.
Oh no, bro. I don't want to take the K pill, bro. I don't want to.
Hi, sister.
Look at my hand. Watch his dumb hand down. There you go.
Oh, that's a good one. You're living in a nice big question.
That's not a nice big question.
Michael wasn't.
Я за эстетику тела,
а
вот
надо
смотреть
за этим. А я
that's it.
My name is Kendall.
So you head to the Nether to farm blazes, but blazes don't spawn. This is Minecraft's only difficulty that is deemed impossible to beat without the help of cheats or specific worlds. But I want to change that, therefore I'm giving myself 24 hours to find a way to beat the game, and if the timer runs out, I'll delete my world. So, is this game mode really impossible? I sure hope not, otherwise I'm to look ridiculous. Now I need blaze rods and ender pearls to beat the game, and frankly, I don't know how I'm gonna do that yet. So we can get back to that later. I think first I want to get myself some iron so I can get myself a portal to the Nether. Probably a good time to mention I was talking to my friend right before this, and he dared me to use the first world that I spawn in, and so I said yes, because apparently I'm a sucker for putting myself in a terrible situation. Ooh, lucky village. Honestly, can I just, like... What? You don't even care! Oh my god, this is incredible! I can see why peaceful mode's just the best. I took my new friend Timmy, turned him into a bucket, and used him to make another portal to get blaze logs.
Okay, this is a guy I just drafted, didn't I?
Why do I keep forgetting that peaceful mode doesn't spawn the blaze logs? This is the part where everyone that's tried to beat the game in peaceful mode has failed. Obtaining blaze rods. In order to beat the game, blaze rods are a required step. If we were playing on easy or even hard difficulty, we can just walk into another fortress, find a blaze spawner, and kill a blaze. No problem. But since we're playing on peaceful difficulty, Minecraft doesn't allow blazes or any other hostile mob to spawn. So, the answer seems obvious. If blazes don't spawn, surely it's an impossible task. But, I'm not giving up that easy. So I did some research. After quite a bit of research, I stumbled across this video showcasing a method to obtain blaze rods in peaceful mode. This sounds perfect. It seems like the exact solution to my problem. However, there's cats. Because in order to obtain the blaze rods, I would need to downgrade my world to version 1.0, the oldest version of Minecraft. Now, downgrading a world isn't really a new concept, but that doesn't make it any less dangerous. Your entire inventory gets deleted, world generation gets corrupted, and Minecraft starts to crash constantly. Now, like I said before, I'm only playing on this single world. Safely loading another world isn't an option.
So I made myself a backup and began the downgrade. Break on me now. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Oh, this game is so laggy. I don't know if this is playable.
What is this?
What? Oh my god, no. I'm actually gonna break my game. Oh. Crap. Thankfully, a quick restart of Minecraft seems to have solved my problem. However, I'm not quite out of the woods yet. Now, the dude who made that video, Crafter Dark, I don't even know if the video's legit. It could be fake for all I know. But the dude is claiming that there are actually blazes spawning in the Nether. I don't know, I kinda wanna check that out, so I guess we'll go back to the Nether.
Father, I hear voices. Father. Father.
And then you fall over cry because he hears voices. I don't know. You do that path thing.
So I found the G on my second attempt. See, there was almost just live. Whatever, I'm scared. It's back. See, live. Live. JT live the not lives. Okay, then I just hit this. And now we get off JT live.
This is charged lemonade from Panera and pizza for signature.
You are possessed.
Welcome to GT Not Live, where today we're visiting the most mysterious place in all of FNAF lore, Juniors. So this is a FNAF fan game that I've seen a decent amount of hype around in the lead up to its eventual release here. And now it's available. It literally just dropped today, yesterday, I don't know. I don't know. The time has no meaning. We also exist on the internet, so this video could be watched years from now. So maybe this video, you know, hey, Junior just launched 5 years ago. I don't know. But anyway, I've seen a lot of talk about this new Snap fan game, Junior, and I'm interested in checking it out. Not because like, I just like trying different Snap fan games than we have done in one in a while, but more so because it taps into, I'm assuming, what is the most mysterious location in Snap 4, which is Junior's, right? So for those of you who don't remember, in Snap 6, during the Midnight Motorist minigame, right, you kind of branch off the path of the minigame, and you drive around, and there is your purple car. Specifically, purple guy's car is able to visit a parking lot.
Exactly.
And out front of a building labeled Junior's is a bodyguard or a bouncer who says, hey, you know you're not allowed to come here anymore, get out of here, whatever. At which point then your orange guy, you go back to your house, you're like, where's my son? The window's broken, all that stuff. But no one has ever really known what Junior's is, right? Like, I came up with some... They're not my favorite series about like what they are. Like at one point, I'm like, oh, maybe it's the new location of FNAF, or maybe it's an earlier location, a newer location. A lot of people, the most common theory around it is that it is a bar, and that William Afton is drinking, and that he's not allowed to come back. He's, you know, oh, I got too sloppy or messy or whatever. Get out of here. You're not allowed to come back. I don't know. Honestly, to this day, if you were to ask me, like, what is one thing that you, if I could ask Scott Kaufman to answer one thing about the franchise, I think that would be up there. I'd have to really think about what that question would be, but that is always one that's persisted in my mind. I'm like, what do you mean by that? Like, was it meant to be a bar? What's going on? Actually, a lot of my questions would be about the FNAF 6 Midnight Motors minigame, because there's also the random like pile of dirt in the middle of the forest that you find, a grave to something, is it a reference to the Twisted Ones? We don't know. Like, of everything in FNAF lore, I think you could cobble together a rough timeline, you can cobble together rough answers. It might not be entirely true, but you can roughly get what was meant. Pile of dirt is Junior.
You have a little windy spring.
I get it. It's jump scaring. It's the jump scare. It's the jump scare hair.
Scare hair.
Jump scare hair. Yeah. How is it? Is it good?
It's so thin now.
Good.
Yeah. No, I'm done. For now. Ouch. Oh, I'm not meant to be trying to fix a team. I'm meant to be watching how K-Nas does through the end of his career. His entire career. Can I check where the dragway is real quick? And their Trey Lance that they for some reason have. Five-year deal. Now this is a push beyond the lines. God damn, his last year on the Jags affect nothing. Like, holy cow. He started lighting people off with the Jags Lions. I'm gonna check the playoff bracket. The Lions are not here. I shall check their record. I told you what to be ready. 5-12. God damn it. Punctual my proper name. On the dot is not your aim. All the we and low, we are not the same. I hit you in that silly.
Hello? Hello, Pito. Hello.
Hello?
Dude, stop. No, no, no.
I've been cutting on the lamb and the Benz coupe.